Well then, my beloved people of YouTube, guess what? Guess what happened? So, you may recognize this place. We ended the game here yesterday, and well, yesterday I was recording the last time, so I came back to record today again. And well, I found Fist. Fist is here. You know, we're moving around. But then I went to the inventory, and yeah, we were robbed. So there's a mechanic in the game that I didn't really understand very well at the time. And the mechanic is that your body stays in the game. So I realized, I found out about this a bit too late. And someone found our beautiful, beautiful body and robbed it of everything that it had. I think that is anyway how it works. So next time in this episode, when we quit out and go away, I'm gonna try to put her somewhere in a slightly less obvious place, one that is not on the top of a hill, surrounded by nothing between a stick and a wall. So in this episode, what I'm gonna do, I'm going to try to do it anyway. I'm going to, again, try to get some clothes back on. Try to get some primitive weapons that we have. Good thing we didn't have much. That's the good bit. We are quite hungry, though, so I need to start looking for food, you know, unless I want to starve. But then, as soon as I have all the stuff, I'm going to try to attempt to find a dodo and tame it. It's the easiest animal to tame. It still takes quite a bit of effort. So we're going to try and do that, see if that works out, and that's going to be the goal for today. Probably going to cut out a lot of the stuff here, because I will have to do some very basic things again, since, again, you know, we have nothing. And I will see you at the point where we can already go probably looking for the dodo to tame. You know what I'm thankful, though, for, is that they didn't take us to the prison, because I've heard there have prisons in this game. Like, they drag you some place you can't get out of while you're unconscious, and you wake up, and hello. Oh, hello, there's a guy here. Hello, servitude. Hello, sir, how are you today? Greetings. Good day. Press B to talk by default. I'm gonna keep my distance, I don't know. I don't know if this guy's... it's good intentions or bad intentions. First human, though. It's pretty cool. First human. Wish I was a bit better dressed for the occasion. I can hardly stay alive, you know, stay conscious with the amount of food I have. Well, let's actually eat all this stuff. If he kills us or something, at least we'll have a better chance to fight if this guy decides to attack us. But I think, I'm just gonna go away. I tried to communicate. He was not very responsive to my communication. So I'm just gonna go. He could be like talking to his friends on TeamSpeak or something like that, and telling, "Hey, I found someone here. We could take him to the prison. You know, the prison, the one you heard about, where you wake up and you're in prison and you can't get out. That kind of stuff." So I don't really. I kind of would rather not get involved in that sort of situation. If you know what I mean. Well, it seems like the gentleman isn't following me. There's a dodo here. I'm gonna kill it just for points and meat. Actually, I can start taming this dodo. Because I already have this... oh, wow. Look at the lag. So, the way you tame animals... yeah, in case I haven't mentioned this... this is kind of a dangerous place to tame anyone, because there's I noticed a house nearby. But the way you do it, you put food in their inventory, and they eat it. And as long as they're eating it, they're happy, and they're getting tamed. Another thing you need to do, you need to put a lot of narco berries in them as well. And every once in a while, you remote use the berries, so that keeps them unconscious. And then when the taming meter fills up, the dodo will be tamed. Kind of simple as that, and also kind of boring as that, because, well, again, dodo is the easiest one to tame. And they're pretty cute when they're tamed, like, they follow you around like a awkward goose, I guess. And you can even order them to attack, I believe. I haven't really tried it, but I believe you have, like, a couple of dodos. You just tell them, "Hey, dodos, go after that person over there," or something, and they'll do it. So that's pretty cool. But... it takes about 15 minutes, maybe, or maybe 10 minutes to tame a dodo. And you gotta keep them Again, you gotta keep them narco buried up. Oh shit, no, don't. Oh no, where's my narco berries? Those are hard to come by. Okay, give them the narco berries. Narco berries, that's a funny name. Okay, and so that's to keep the turper up to the maximum amount. Well, ideally the maximum amount. And the rest of the stuff, also need to watch that we don't, like, starve, is just to keep them taming, I guess, in the taming position. I don't know what's the correct biological definition of, I don't know if people used to, like, well, people met dodos, right? Dodos are not as old as dinosaurs. So I guess someone must have tried to tame them, and probably this was the way. They would give them narco berries, and the dodos would be like, yeah, narco berries. I would like to get tamed, sir. Still worried about that guy over there, but haven't seen him in a bit, so that's okay. I guess we could just tame the dodo first and worry about, like, having clothes and weapons and whatever and later. I don't think I would have a fighting chance with what I had before anyway, so it's okay. Oh, more narco berries, that's cool. Okay, that didn't go so well. My dodo died, so we'll find a new one. I'll just get a bit more prepared for dodo taming. Maybe I need like 20, up to 20 narco berries. And we'll definitely do it. Meanwhile, we gotta let's take care of ourselves here quickly. I'm gonna eat all this stuff but for the purpose of getting water actually from the berries, because we're a little bit away from the beach, which is okay. And I'm gonna quickly explore, take a look at this one. Look at this. This is metal building. This is pretty pretty hard to make. I wonder if anyone's inside. I guess they are inside. And then they have like a little yard back here, which is pretty cool. So they have a stone building with some metal parts. Oh, this has been raided, hasn't it? Because this is open. And there's like a hole over there? No, this is just the foundation, I think. So this is pretty, like, this takes a lot of effort to get metal, this amount of metal anyway. Yeah, I think someone broke into here. They probably had their dinos stored in here. And they probably stole them or killed them or whatever. That's probably what happened. So meanwhile, I'm just gonna try to get to the level where I can actually tame a dodo. It was a bit of a premature attempt at taming a dodo and didn't really go too well. Kind of my fault, really, for getting robbed and... Is it raining? Yeah. And, oh, rain refills water. Ah, that's great. So we don't really need to worry about that anymore. But yeah, I'll see you when we can actually tame a dodo. That's how I'm gonna put it. Oh, look, I found a sign. It says, move along, nothing to see here. And I agree. There is really nothing to see here. Okay, I think we're okay now. Let's take a look at that building over there, see what's going on. And then I'm gonna go back up there, or maybe I'll find a dodo here. It seems like we have enough. Like, I have 16 narco berries. I think we can do that, and I have a lot of other berries as well. We got our trousers back. Oh, one of the narco berries just spoiled. We also got our shirt back. The shoes and gloves are going to take a bit more doing because... Oh, look, they put it up right up there. It says, take what you need, share what you want. Oh, really? Oh, there's a pin code? 1, 2, 3, 4. I love that there's a pin code on 6969. Alright, yeah, I don't know what the pin code is. They should have left the pin code on the sign if they were, you know, so much into sharing. So, that's pretty cool, I guess, that they want to share, but also a bit weird. That's a thatched roof. They could get through that pretty easily with it, like a hatchet in a minute. I'm not going to do that. Or am I? And no, okay, we have goals. We need to stick to our goals. We gotta find a dodo and tame a dodo, and then maybe we can come back here. I mean, this is gonna stay here. I'm always joining the same server. So, that should be okay. As long as we can complete our today's goal, then we're good. We can continue with other goals. Like, one of them could be break into these guys' house. Why not? Because they have a critical flaw there. Like, that top bit with the thatch, that's very easy to get through. The wood would take more work, and I don't really have... I don't know, anything really for wood. I could probably get through it eventually with a primitive hatchet. Oh god, I thought it was just a crash. But this is going to take such a long time that I'm not going to bother with that. I don't know why I'm collecting more berries. Oh, there you go, narco berries. Good. Narco berries are good. We just need to find some dodos. Hopefully they didn't all just get wiped out like in real life. Which could happen. I could go up there again and see if there's any dodos. I'm just going to quickly take a look at here. See if there are any dodos over here. There's another house here. This is... Oh, I just defecated like 3 times apparently or something. That's the sign. I don't remember this house being here. But maybe I'm missing something. A lot of them seem to be intact, which is interesting. Who's this for? Kingdom Hearts. Zombie. Does that have a roof? Doesn't have a roof. Does it have... That's interesting. I could jump inside... I could jump inside of it. But the problem would be getting out of it, not... get stuck in there. They don't even have anything inside. It's empty on the inside. I could have used that rock over there and jump in it, but... there's really no point currently. I don't see any animals. Oh, wait. There you go, there's a dodo. Cool. Cool. Hey, dodo. Hey, buddy. Where'd he go? Oh, okay. He's not dead, right? Alright, excellent. So he's unconscious. We're gonna give him all the berries in the world. Okay, not all the berries, but like all these berries. That should be more than enough. I'm gonna put all the narco berries in the dodo. And now we just need to wait, essentially. This is what I tried to do last time as well, but I didn't have enough narco berries, I think. Wow, he's really... They're regaining consciousness very quickly. Is this after... There was an update today. Maybe this is like a result of that. So we're just going to try to... Is this one of the berries just waking it up or something? Quite weird. Oh my god, this dodo really wants to stay untamed, huh? Hopefully this is going to be enough. There's no taming meter here, on this screen, but, I mean, he went to, like, 1/5 of taming process, I guess, so that's okay. Let's collect all the stuff that is here, maybe we get, like, more narco berries as a result. Hopefully no one notices us that we're here, and we should be okay. Steam berries. Hopefully I won't give the steam berries to the dodo by accident. That would be pretty devastating. Alright, let's see what's the deal. Dodo's getting there. I wonder if you give them like too many narco berries, they slow down their taming process because they're just under the influence. This dodo should not be driving any heavy machinery, or operating rather any heavy machinery, I think. Okay, that's like a third of the taming done. 72.6. percent efficiency. That's a high efficiency. I'm not sure what the efficiency actually depends on. If you know, please let me know down below in the comments. We probably need to make a torch in case it gets pretty dark here. Alright, cool. And it will get pretty dark. I don't have a technology for standing torch, do I? Let's find out. No, I could make a campfire technically. It would take a bit more thatch and a bit more stones. But we'll do that after we tame the dodo. I think the dodo taming comes first, and everything else would come second to that. See, the taming efficiency is falling somehow, and it seems to fall usually after a few minutes of the taming process. I don't know if this is by default. If this is working as it should be, or this is some kind of glitch, you know, because the game is in early access, etc., etc. We definitely have. I feel like we have enough narco berries to keep this happening, to make this happen. That's over 50% tamed. Not too bad. Even though it has fallen to 10% in efficiency, we should be okay. And that's the same old obelisk that was there the last few times. I'm also playing like a single player version of this when I'm not recording, because just to find out, like, just to know a bit more about crafting and what I can make, so I don't sound like a complete idiot when I make these videos. And I still haven't managed to open any of those supply crates. I don't even know what's inside of them. Oh wow, this guy is actually gonna wake up now. Okay, narcoberries to the rescue. And more narcoberries to the rescue. More rescue, more berries, more rescue. Okay, a bit, one more. Okay, fully unconscious. Still eating, glitching through the ground. We need to also name it. When you have to name it your pet, when you, or your dinosaur, whatever, in this case your dodo, when you tame them. And I think I have a perfect name for it. You'll see when we're done with the process. So this is uncut taming right here. This is how long it actually takes to do it. We're also cold, apparently. Well, I guess we are, because we're barefoot and no gloves. Gloves off. 52%. Still good. It's still pretty good level of taming. I'm going to take a lot of this stuff away because it doesn't... I think it has enough food as it is. And then we can use it for our own nutrition. I think the dodo is going to use up all the berries. I can leave the rest of the berries with dodo, and then and they can use it as food, as our pet. One more narco berry. Oh, there we go. You have tamed the dodo in a terrible font of a terrible color in a terrible interface. Alright, so what I'm going to call this dodo is David Cameron. There we go. David Cameron is our dodo. You can see the name appears there. Yeah, David Cameron is... Oh my god, was that... Oh, just a knight? Okay. Is level 11 dodo. And I believe if I press... If I move away a little bit... Let's actually get a torch here so you can see David. David will follow us. If I get away... Get quite far away from David. He's gonna... I can't say it probably. Let's go over here. He runs in a very cute fashion. Oh, there you go. there's David Cameron running after you. So, that's how you tame animals. This is the easiest one, and hence it takes the least amount of time. I've only tamed one other creature so far, and that creature took quite a bit longer, maybe like 15, 20 minutes. It was like a Philosaurus or something like that, or something. It looks like a giant pig. If you played this game, you've probably seen it. And I tamed that guy, and he could ride around on him. He's not very strong. Also, he wasn't probably leveled up properly, but it gives you a means of transportation, and you can haul stuff in it. So you need to carry, you know, 500 wood or something because you're building something somewhere else. Then you take this giant wild pig with you and put all the stuff on him, and he will carry it for you. So in that sense, it is pretty useful. But that's like my taming experience right there. And even that I achieved because I was playing single player and I was playing it with the... They're not very fast, the dodos. Especially David. David isn't the sharpest tool in the box, is he? So, as I was talking about taming... Yeah, so I used like 3x experience and 3x resources on the single player just to quickly see how things work out and, you know, what needs doing when, etc., etc. So... even then, it takes quite a bit of time. So, I guess this is very much to make you interact with other players and to make you... Oh, did David Cameron just poop? Let's poop in support of... Oh, I'm not ready to poop anyway. Alright, never mind. That is probably to make you join a tribe and be part of a tribe and be potentially... do some teamwork and make the tasks easier, because some of the tasks are pretty hard to do. Alright, we're gonna go leveled up. Let's increase our weight. Maybe we can carry, that would be useful, since we only have a dodo, and I don't think we're gonna get anything else anytime soon. We could probably get some kind of box, but I don't think we'll be able to really store anything in there. What's the other useful stuff that we can actually have? Maybe we could get a flag. Flags are fun, aren't they? I would probably need to... I'm not sure if I need to have the mortar and pestle to actually get dyes to work. I haven't actually tested it out. But oh, Fiomia is that pig thing that you can. This is a saddle for it. Maybe you can also get a simple bed for respawning. But again, I tried the slingshot. It wasn't very good. I never actually managed to knock anyone out with a slingshot, even though it is essentially for that. It's a knockout weapon. So probably the best way to do knockout is with arrows dipped in narcotics, which is something you see here. But I haven't really managed to get up to that level where I can actually use it. So you know, and now again, I'm talking about the single player stuff. So I don't know. I don't know what is the best thing for right now. We can even actually just wait since we're not really crafting anything currently. And let's try and get in the. Okay, those dinos were a bit scary for a moment. Let's try to get into their house. Let's see if that actually works out. For that to work out, obviously, I need to be on top of their house. And I don't think I can necessarily get on top of the roof. So maybe that's a bad idea. Could I actually go prone here? And no, I can't really go prone either. So thatch floor. If I remove the thatch floor, then I probably can get into that house. I don't know. Maybe we could try it. Why am I? Okay, I think I was a bit stuck underneath. Wood floor. That's the thatch floor, isn't it? So let's see if that actually works out. Again, sorry about the darkness. So thatch floor 2, 3, 5, 8. It's still 2, 3, 5, 8. Try it that way. Okay, it does actually work. So I'm gonna do this for some time and see if I can get into their house and see what's inside. Well, you'll be happy to find out we're halfway there. That's half the damage done. I'll see you on the other side. Okay, we're almost there. This is 2 axes broken already. 172 damage left. And we haven't been caught yet. It'd be kind of funny if they catch us, obviously, but also kind of scary. I'm kind of a bit worried also that there's could be some traps inside the house. Something I haven't seen before, I don't know. We'll find out. 25, 18, 11, 4. There's a dude sleeping in there, level 12. Oh wow, this is weird. Okay. Can I still not get through? Okay, so this guy's inventory. That's all he has? I'll take the slingshot, I guess. Do I have a hat? I guess. There's just a dude sleeping there, that's it. What can I? I'm prone right now, right? Maybe I should just remove the weapon. How can I just not get through? I don't know if you can see this guy, but there you go. It's right there. They have some. If only I could get on the roof, I could then get through. It doesn't seem like it's possible to just squeeze in there. So this is prone, this is up, and this is crouched? Alright, this is crouched, and this is prone. And I can't get in. This is very strange, I find it quite strange. What are more options about this? I can actually drag him out. This is kinda cool. Am I still dragging him? I am, yeah. Okay. Let's take him somewhere else. Be funny if he wakes up right now. I kinda like this mechanic. I think this is pretty cool. And David Cameron is following us as well. So that's cool. Let's take him somewhere to the forest. Where are we? I can drag him like this. I don't actually have to drag him in the other way. Wait, can I? Why am I crouched? Okay. So, drag him. Oh, I have to... I can't see anything in the forest because I have to extinguish the torch in order to drag him. Alright, that's fine. Let's just leave him here. I think this is funny enough. Where is he? There you go. He's just going to be sleeping here. He's going to wake up and go, oh my god, I have been transported for 7 million miles. But actually, he's just right there. His house is right here. So, that was kind of cool. That was interesting. You know what I was thinking while I was doing all this shenanigans with the floor? I wondered if they actually put the pin somewhere, but they didn't put the pin in over there, so I don't know how you're meant to get into their house and share, because they said, take what you want, share what you can. While I'm kind of unable to take what I want. All I could take was his slingshot. Yeah, this is either a bug that he can't crawl under there, or where's my dodo? David! What's wrong with David? Yo, David, here. Over here. Alright, cool. So yeah, I'm not sure what exactly was going on there in terms of me not being able to crawl under. But that was pretty cool. So we tamed the dodo, broke into someone's house, kind of. If I had better weapons, I mean, that would be much easier to do. We could probably peruse some of their items as well. But no such luck. Now, what we need to do now, probably, now that it's also the sun's coming up, we need to find a peaceful place to pass out. So maybe somewhere a little bit more inland. We should probably also eat a lot more berries before we do that. So maybe, like, almost all of these. This thing uses rocks to fire, by the way, so I can actually show you. So put it over here. So you have 11 in your clip, which means that you have 12 rocks and one of them is loaded. So if I were to press 7 and get the slingshot out, I could either just fire the slingshot like that without aiming and the rock goes somewhere, or I could aim sort of and fire like that and still need to press left button to fire, left mouse button, and then you fire like that. Hey, Triceratops. And that's how the slingshot works. Alright, so let's continue on our way to the forest and find some relatively peaceful place to pass out, because since we don't have a house, and I don't think we'll manage to find a house necessarily, or get a house of our own, just because of how much effort it takes and how unfeasible it is, really, in PvP servers like this one, where you can actually damage. I kind of looked into that. So in PvP, you can damage people and their belongings, and on PvE, you cannot. So you can actually not harm anyone unless you somehow manage to drag them into the sea and they drown or something like that. So you could technically still drown. Not sure about this place. Maybe go down here. I could pass out right here. I think this is as good a place as any. Where's our dodo? Where's David Cameron? Where's David Cameron? Oh, well, I guess, you know, that happens. Camera's Britain, right? Farewell, David Cameron. Hopefully you'll have a better life without me. On that happy thought, I'm gonna end the video here. It is my fervent hope that you enjoyed this audiovisual video game experience. If you haven't done so already, please consider subscribing to Rock Paper Shotgun right here on YouTube. And if you would like to see even more videos from yours truly, there should be some appropriate links in the description of this video. May you have a truly glorious day, and I will see you in the next one.